A federal investigation into the police force in Cleveland. The investigation underway even before what we've now learned. A 12-year-old boy shot and killed by an officer, the boy holding a toy gun. It happened less than 2 seconds after the officer arrived, and this surveillance video shows the boy near the gazebo there, the officer pulling up, and of course we know what happens next. Tonight we learn when that officer was hired, there were never questions about his behavior while on a police force before. ABC senior justice correspondent Pierre Thomas tonight.
Tamir Rice, just 12 years old, laid to rest after being fatally shot by a police officer who mistakenly thought the boy had a deadly firearm. But tonight there are disturbing questions about whether that officer should have ever been hired by the Cleveland police. Officer Tim Loman had recently resigned from a nearby department that was already contemplating firing him. One supervisor writing, his handgun performance was dismal, that he became distracted and weepy during firearms training, concluding that due to this dangerous loss of composure during live training, I do not believe Loman shows the maturity needed to work in our employment. But stunningly, Cleveland police admit they never checked Loman's personnel file before hiring him.
He absolutely should not have been a police officer.
The officer's judgment is a crucial question. The boy was shot dead less than 2 seconds after Loman's patrol car pulled up. The boy's gun, just a toy. The community outraged.
His young, fragile life was snuffed out like a candle in the wind.
Cleveland's force had been under federal investigation before the shooting, and today the Attorney General announced this damning assessment.
The Cleveland Division of Public Police engages in a pattern and practice of using excessive force.
David, tonight no comment from Officer Loman as the city grieves for a little boy and comes to terms with the conduct of its police.
Pierre Thomas, live in Washington. Pierre, thank you.